Hi YouTube, welcome to another episode of the 100 days of Webflow journey. This is episode 20 and today we're gonna create some horizontal scrolling on Webflow using GSAP. It's gonna be a very nice tutorial. I will walk you through it step by step, and also I'll leave a link to this in the description below. I know this is a use case that is asked for a lot, so you guys can clone the project and make use of it yourselves. So without further ado, let's get to it. I have this landing page here. It has this one full page section, this another full page section, and in between it I want to create this horizontal scroll. There will be four slides, four full page sections that I want to scroll through them horizontally. So let's see how to do that. Now I have this div here that's called horizontal scroll, and this is where I want to build my horizontal scroll. And let's start by adding a div block. We're gonna name this div block wrapper. And wrapper, as you can see, it comes in display flex, and it's a direction horizontal. And then we're gonna align it to the left, and then we're gonna stretch the y-axis. Inside the wrapper, I'm gonna add another div block, and this div block is gonna be called sticky. And I've already set this up, so in sticky, the sizing will be don't shrink or grow. I have some padding here for the sake of styling, and then the width will be 100 dynamic view width. The height will be 100 dynamic view height. And then inside sticky, I'm gonna add another element, which will be image. And we're gonna add this image. Perhaps we're gonna add this one. And now we have this sticky element. It's a full page, an image that is inside our wrapper. Now I want to create more than one, so I'm gonna create four. And I'm gonna change the image by going to the settings panel and changing the image for each one. So this one will be this, the third one will be this one, and then the fourth one will be replace, will be this one. Now that we set them up, we can see that this scrolls to the side and not in the way that we want. So we're gonna go to our page wrap and set the overflow to clip, and this way it's always 100% view width. And then we're gonna control the horizontal scroll with GSAP. So let's do that. Now we're gonna go to our page settings. We're gonna go to the before close body tag, and we're gonna copy a code that, again, I will leave this project and the code in the description below so you guys can copy this. So first, the codes are gonna be the library of GSAP and the scroll trigger. Now, I always advise to get the most up-to-date version from the GSAP website, so you can go to GSAP and get the most up-to-date version. So this is 3.12.5, and this is the most up-to-date as per this video. So then we write the script, which is calling scroll trigger. We're measuring the length of the sticky element. So I have four of them. So here I'm measuring the length, and this is dynamic so that if I add more sticky elements, it's gonna automatically adapt. We're moving across the wrapper element, which contains all those sticky div blocks. And then we're setting up these options. So the start and the end is the total sections times 600 view height. Now this 600 is for the sake of the speed. You can adjust this number. Ideally it's 100, but 100 is super fast, so I put larger number. We have pin set to true, scrub as well. This is something that you can adjust. This is the smoothness of how much there is a delay between the scroll and the effect on the screen. Pin is basically to pin everything to the screen, and then snap is to snap to the next section if I scroll midway between the two. So let's see this in action. Now I'm gonna save and I'm gonna publish, and we're gonna see this in action. All right, so it's published, so I can go see my live website. If I scroll down, I can see that it starts scrolling as I wanted, and if I scroll back up, it scrolls, and as you can see, it has this speed. And if I go midway between one of the slides, it just goes to the next one. So this is nice. So we can snap to the next slide. And that's basically it. Thank you for watching the video. I hope you guys liked it, and I'll see you in the next one.